Hello everyone, good afternoon. I have recently created a new Google Cloud account, so I'm going to create some new tutorials on Google Cloud, and I will display how we can use Google Cloud to host our basic applications like WordPress hosting, maybe Magento hosting, etc. So let's start to do this. First, I need to create an instance, which is virtual machines in Google. Let's go to VM instances. And then I'm going to create a new VM instance. Region, let's keep it as it is, US Central 1. Then one virtual CPU, 3.75 GB of memory, that's fine. Let's choose the OS. OS should be Ubuntu 18. Then we set allow HTTP and HTTPS. Okay, wait. Okay, it's done. I'm going to connect to that instance via SSH, so let's do that. Okay, great, it's connected, so let's update the APT. Okay, then I'm going to install Apache. It is installing Apache and PHP 7.2. Let's start Apache. Okay. Let's verify whether it has been successfully installed. Okay, it is installed successfully, and then I'm going to install MySQL. Let's just install MySQL. Then I'm going to download a WordPress. And also I need to set a domain, cloud DNS. Copy link. Now I'm going to download the WordPress into the root directory. Okay, it has been downloaded. Now I'm going to unzip it. I'm going to rename the HTML directory and then rename the WordPress to the HTML directory. Okay, that's there. Then I'm going to log into MySQL server and set up the passwords. Now I'm going to run this MySQL command here. So you can see by default in Ubuntu the root user has a authentication socket. We need to change that so that it is now becoming MySQL native password. Okay, so let me update that. SQL native password. User equals root. Okay, let's run this, and now we are going to okay. So I'm going to flush privileges. Oh, sorry, I need to update the password. I've written the query here. I'm going to update the MySQL password. And then flush privileges. Yes. sometimes I get typing mistakes, so just check it in the online. Okay, so now exit, and then I'm going to connect to MySQL. MySQL minus root minus p, and I'm going to give the passwords, which is this one. Okay, I have now successfully connected. That's great, and then I'm going to create a database. Oops, again typing mistake. Create schema. Create database WordPress. Okay, so the problem was with my comma. So let's clear this out, and let's exit and clear the window. That's fine. Now I'm going to set the DNS, which I use free DNS. Okay, I give the IP address. And then I save. So it's WordPress.sitesandshops.com. Let's see if I can browse it. Still not. Let's try to see here. PHP extension request request MySQL extension is required. Okay, we have installed PHP without MySQL, so let's install PHP MySQL extension. I'm feeling a bit sick today, so that's why I'm having a lot of mistakes, especially spelling mistakes, and also sometimes I just forget the commands. Okay, so I'm going to install via the IP address. So here is the default page of WordPress installation. So let's go. Database name WordPress, username root, password, get the password. Okay, let's try. Okay, we can write up, that's fine. We can do that by ourselves. Okay, we have updated the config file, and then we continue the installation. Run the installer. Okay, site title GCP WordPress. I would say test, and the password is a good one. Install WordPress. Perfect. We'll give a test password, and we have successfully finished the WordPress installation. That's quite handy. Let's see if we have our domain is prepared. No, it takes some time, so okay, I will get a new video, and let's pause this today. Next video I will show you link the domain with this WordPress site and set up SSL over there. So thank you for watching my video, and hope you will subscribe to my channel. Thank you, and bye.